So the charge then can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be transferred from one body to the another body. You know, conservation of energy. While defining conservation of energy, we can say the total energy, energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be transferred from one form to the another form. One form, heat energy, mechanical energy, potential energy, kinetic energy, like that transfer of energy from one form to the another form. But charge can transfer from one body to the another body. So charge can neither be created nor destroyed. This is a third property of electric charge. Okay. So in addition to this, there is another important point is there. So this was asked in previous AIIMS examination. Electric charge is invariant. Electric charge is invariant, which means by motion of the charges, by motion of the charge, electric charge, by motion of the charge, its value, its charge, or its magnitude of charge, magnitude of charge does not change. For example, one sphere is there, it is having a charge of 10 coulomb. In the case of rest, now this sphere is moving with some velocity. Because of this motion of this sphere, there is no change in the value of charge. That is called electric charge is invariant. Electric charge is invariant. So based on three methods to produce electrification, we discussed about three processes or three methods. They are rubbing or frictional electricity, conduction, induction. And then electric charge, what is electric charge? And what are the units? What is meant by electric charge and all? And then properties of electric charge. So based on this entire area, we'll go for some numericals. Then we can discuss the concept of Coulomb's law. Okay. Before this one, file is there. Electric charge, field lines, field dipole, electric charge. Before. One minute, I will place this one also. So in that file, some questions missed. Okay, right. So these are the questions based on. Initially, sphere A has a charge of minus 50 E. You know what is E? Basic value of charge, that is 1.6 into rho minus 19 coulombs. A sphere having a minus 50 E. For example, this is a sphere of sphere A having charge minus 50 E. And sphere B has a charge of plus 20 E. That means another sphere is there. This is of plus 20 E. This is sphere B. The spheres are made up of conducting materials and are identical in size. Sizes are same. This is R and this is also R. Size is same. So size is same means equally charge will equally be distributed. Now, if the spheres touch with each other, what is the resulting charge on sphere A? Now, these two are touching with each other. When two bodies are touching with each other, what happens? Redistribution of charges will happen by the process of conduction. So when the two charges are combined together, what is the net charge of this one? Minus 50 plus 20. Minus 50 plus 20. So what is the net charge? By using additivity of electric charge, we can use Q1 plus Q2. Minus 50 plus 20. So that means minus 30 E. So net charge is minus 30 E. So this net charge of minus 30 E will equally distribute on these two spheres. Because both are having same size. So on this minus 15 E, like that, charges will redistribute on the two spheres. This is by the process of conduction. So the conduction precedes repulsion because same charge is lying on the both bodies. So minus 15 E plus 15, minus 15 E, minus 15 E. Like that, charge will redistribute on the two spheres as they are having same size. If they are having different size, we can take Q1 is equal to R1 by R1 plus R2 into total charge Q. The total charge is minus 30. If these two are different, we can use this expression to calculate Q1 charge on first sphere. In the same way, Q2 charge on sphere, the second sphere, R2 by R1 plus R2 into total charge Q. Like that, we can calculate the value of Q1 and Q2 charge on the two spheres after connect with each other. This is Aligarh Muslim University in the year of 2015. They asked this question. Understood? The total charge will redistribute equally on the two spheres by the process of conduction as they are equal in size means equally distributed. Unequal in sizes means we can use this these formulas to calculate the values of charges. Clear? Next question. The number of electrons in 1 coulomb of charge, this already we calculated as an example, that is 6.25 into 10 to the 18 electron, that is Comet K, 2015 Comet K examination, they asked this question. So, you know, according to quantization condition, Q is equal to N E, so N is equal to Q by E. From this relation, we can calculate 6.25 into 10 to the 18 electrons. Right, next step. Identify the wrong statement. Charge is a vector quantity. Electric charge is a scalar quantity. So this is wrong statement. So this is only correct option. Current is a scalar quantity. So current is also scalar quantity. We'll discuss in the chapter of current electricity. We'll discuss current as a scalar quantity. This is also correct statement. Charge can be quantized. One of the property. Charge is additive in nature. One of the property. Charge is conserved, one of the property of electric charge. So, electric charge is a vector quantity is wrong statement. So, that is the correct option. Right, next. If a charge on the body is 1 nanocoulomb, then how many electrons are present on the body? The charge on the body is 1 nanocoulomb, then how many electrons are present on the body? So by the process of quantization condition, Q is equal to Ne. Now N is equal to Q by E. What is Q? 1 nanocoulomb. Nano means 1 × 10⁻⁹ by −9 coulomb. What is the value of E? 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. Now coulomb get cancelled. This 1 by 1.6 is nothing but 0.625 into this will becomes 10⁻⁹ - 9 will becomes cancelled, 10⁻¹. This will be equal to 6.25 × 10⁻⁹. So 6.25 × 10⁻⁹. Okay. Next, electric charge does not have which of the following properties? Total charge is conserved, quantization of charge, two types of charges, circular line of force, D option. The number of electrons in 2 coulombs of charge. So 1 coulomb of charge consists of 6.25 × 10⁻⁸ electrons. 2 coulomb of charge means 2 × 6.25 × 10⁻⁸, 2 × 6.25 = 12.5 × 10⁻⁸ electrons. Okay. 2 coulombs, 1 coulomb, 6.25. So 2 coulombs, 2 × 6.25. Next. You see this question. One metallic sphere A is given positive charge. One metallic sphere A is given positive charge. What is meant by positive charge? Lack of electrons. Lack of electrons will give positive charge, which means you can take a metal sphere A. This is given a positive charge, which means electrons are transferred from this body to another body. Right. Next, whereas another identical metallic sphere B. So this is A sphere. This is another identical sphere B. Exactly same mass. Mass of the bodies A and B is same. Exactly same mass as of A is given equal amount of negative charge. So what is meant by negative charge? The excess of electrons will give negative charge, which means from another body, electrons are transferred to this body. Then what happens when a body is positively charged? Electrons are transferred from body to the another, which means mass of the body will slightly decreases. So when a body is positively charged, mass of the body slightly decreases. When the body is negatively charged, the mass of the body slightly increases. That means as this is a negatively charged body, mass of B is greater than the mass of A, because initially both are having same mass and also they are equally charged. So we can get mass of B is increases, because this is negatively charged. Negatively charged means deposit of excess electron. So each electron having mass of electron is 9.1 × 10⁻³¹. This is mass of one electron. How many number of electrons are deposited? That much of that number into this, that much of mass will increases. Next, when 10⁴ electrons number is given, 10⁴ electrons are removed from a neutral metal. So when electrons are removed, what happens? The body will get, when electrons are removed, then body will get positive charge. So when 10⁴ electrons are removed from neutral metal sphere, then the charge on the sphere becomes. So the charge on the becomes will becomes positive charge. So minus 16 is not possible. Minus 32 is also not possible, because by removing of electrons, we'll get positive charge. Now, according to quantization condition, we can use Q is equal to N E. So Q is equal to N is how much? 10 power of 14 into E value 1.6 into 10 power of minus 19 coulomb. Now this is minus 19 minus plus 14 minus 5. So 1.6 into 10 power of minus 5 coulomb, or 16 into 10 power of minus 6 coulomb. This is 16 micro coulomb. This is plus. That is a plus, because electrons are removed. If electrons are deposited, you will get negative charge. So plus 16, minus 16, both are there. So even though we calculated this value, if you not understood this point, removed means positive charge, like that concept you didn't understand means, then you can get doubt between these two options. So when electrons are removed, the body will get positive charge, then you can go with the plus 16 micro coulomb. Next step. So some questions and easy questions I'm leaving. You can go through those questions. Right, you see this one, alpha particle. Charge on alpha particle is, what is meant by alpha particle? That we must know. So helium 2-4. This is atomic number. This is mass number. It has 2 electrons, 2 protons, 2 neutrons. Now, from this helium 2-4, if 1 electron is removed, you will get a plus E charge. Body will get, if from a body, 1 electron is removed, means we'll get plus E charge on the body. 2 electrons are removed, plus 2 into E charge. Now, from this helium 2-4, these 2 electrons have been removed. Then you will get a helium 2 plus ion. Helium 2 plus ion. So this is known as alpha particle. So helium 2 plus ion is known as alpha particle. So alpha particle consists of 2 protons, 2 neutrons. So this is a NEET 2019 question. Alpha particle consists of 2 protons, 2 neutrons, 2 electrons, 2 protons, 2 protons, 2 protons and 2 electrons, like that they will give in these 3 options. So we can go with 2 protons and 2 neutrons. So neutrons having neutral charge, protons having positive charge. How many protons? 2 protons. That means charge of the alpha particle is equal to 2 times charge of the proton. What is the charge of the proton? We know plus E. That means 2 into charge of the proton is plus E. That is 2 into 1.6 into 10 power of minus 19 coulomb, which means 3.2 into 10 power of minus 19 coulomb. That is in option C. Okay. Again, mass of the neutrons. Neutron is a massive particle. So in an atom, neutron is the heavier mass. But in practice, we will take mass of the proton and neutron is same. That means charge of the alpha particle is 2 times charge of the proton, whereas mass of the alpha particle is 4 times mass of the proton. So while they will ask the questions on these mass and charges also, we can remember mass of the alpha particle is 4 times mass of the proton. Charge of the alpha particle is 2 times charge of the proton. Okay, this is also same based on conservation of quantization condition. We can calculate this value. Next, you see this, when a glass rod is rubbed with silk, when a glass rod is rubbed with silk, when two bodies are rubbing with each other, electrons are transferred from lower work function body to the higher work function body. So glass rod is acquiring positive charge by transferring of electrons from glass to the silk. Glass to the silk. That means glass rod will gives. This is getting positive charge by transfer of electrons from glass to the silk. So it gives electrons to the silk. Gives electrons to the silk. Okay. So these are all the questions are from DC Pandey material. DC Pandey material. If you have that book means you can go with those questions. Okay. Then after completion, I already sent, I think so, electric charge related. Yes. Again, I will send today. You can go through these questions. Okay. These are also same. We can go with these points. Okay, so this is a NCERT exemplar question. You see, a polythene NCERT exercise question. A polythene piece rubbed with wool is found to have a negative charge of this much. What charge? Negative charge. If a body is getting negative charge, which means electrons are deposited on polythene. This is wool. So electrons are transferred from wool to the polythene. So there is a reason it is getting negative charge. So what they are asking, estimate the number of electrons transferred from which to which. Electrons are transferred from which to which? Electrons are transferred from wool to the polythene. Wool to the polythene. So this charge is given. We know Q is equal to Ne. So N is equal to Q by E as usual. So N is equal to Q by E. We can calculate this much. Now what happened? Electrons are transferred from wool to the polythene. That is the first one. Is there a transfer of mass from wool to the polythene? Yes. How much mass is transferred? How many number of electrons are transferred? Number of electrons into mass of the each electron will give total mass which is transferred from wool to the polythene. Wool to the polythene. So from this we can here we can make it smaller, then we can go with small n into mass of the electron, that is 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. Then again, how much mass is transferred from wool to the polythene? We can calculate. This is NCERT exercise question. Okay. Right. So these are the example questions from your Chaitanya material only. You can go with these questions. And this is also 0.01% of number of atoms are transferred. Then, yes. These are all solid questions based on what are the model of questions you have done. The same model are also there. We can go with these questions. And then some conceptual questions will be there. At the end, not in this file. Before file, so from Chaitanya material, exercise 1. Conceptual questions are most important from this topic of methods of inducing electricity. That is, rubbing or frictional electricity, conduction and induction. So based on this exercise 1 questions, these are very important from this concept. Due to the motion of the charge, its magnitude does not change. That is the property what we call as electric charge is invariant. Electric charge is invariant. So from this property of invariant, we can say because of motion of the charge, the value of magnitude of the charge does not change. This is the option. Okay. Induction precedes attraction. Why? You are taking a glass rod, you are taking a sphere. This is +2 charge. So it will, opposite charges will induced on nearer end. That means unlike charges will induced on nearer end. Same charges will induced on farther end. Farther end. This is because of attraction. This is because of attraction. Right. When charge is given to a body. That means curvature is more, which means then more charge will be accumulated. So more charge accumulates at regions of large curvature, because size, based on the size, accumulation of the charges will be more. Next, this is a previous question. A soap bubble is given a negative charge, then its radius. So you can take one sphere. As you are given negative charge and positive charge, whatever may be the charge you are giving, these all the charges are like charges. Like charges will repel. So because of the repulsion, the size of the soap bubble will increase. Because like charges will repel with each other. So like charges repel, unlike charges attract with each other. This is known as fundamental law of electrostatics. That's what we discussed while discussion of the concept. This is same as what we done. Two identical metal spheres A and B of exactly equal mass are given equal positive and negative charges respectively. So mass of the A is less than mass of the B, or mass of B is greater than mass of A, because this is negatively charged, mass will increase. Next, charge cannot exist without mass, but mass can exist without charge. This is correct statement, right? Charge cannot exist without mass, because charge is intrinsic property of material particle. So without particle, there is no charge. So charge cannot exist without mass, but mass can exist without charge. Charge is invariant. That already we discussed as one of the property. But mass is variant. That is what we call as m is equal to m naught by 1 minus v square by c square. This is called 10 more minutes it is going to complete. We will complete this session. Okay, so m is equal to m naught by root over 1 minus v square by c square. This is according to theory of relativity, mass will decreases with the increase in velocity of the ball. So this is also correct. Charge is conserved, but mass alone may not be conserved. So mass may not always, mass is conserved sometimes, but no, mass is not always conserved. Then we have variable mass system also we have. So then, and also according to Einstein mass energy relation, E is equal to mc square, energy and mass are mutually convertible. It is converted into other form. So mass cannot be conserved always. So A, B, C, all the statements are true. Okay, right. These are all again repeating. Okay, these are the numericals related to electric charge and its properties. Okay, next concept, Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law. So if two charges, this is Q1 charge and this is Q2 charge, are placed or separated by a distance R, which is placed in vacuum, strictly speaking vacuum, or we can say air or vacuum. Now the force between these two charges, is direct proportional to product of their magnitudes of charges. So modulus of Q1, modulus of Q2 by, so force between these two charges is direct proportional to product of the magnitude of their charges and square, inverse proportional to square of the distance between them. This is a Coulomb's law statement, like Newton's law of gravitation, how we will discuss in the chapter of gravitation. In the same manner, we can take this one. And here, one of the consideration is there regarding this point. For example, these two charges are point charges. What is meant by point charge? When I'm considering about charge, is nothing but any property of any one massive particle. For example, in this case, we have taken one sphere. So this is of another sphere. Now we can take this is of radius r, and this is also radius r. For example, two spheres are separated by distance of 30 centimeter. Radius of the sphere is 10 centimeter. This radius of the sphere is also 10 centimeter. So this is the charge Q1 is lying on this sphere. The charge Q2 is lying on this sphere. Then what is the value of r? What is r? R is the separation between the two charges. Now we should take the r value from center to center. Center to center means what is the value of r? Distance between the two spheres is nothing but distance between centers of the two spheres. That means this is 10, this is 30, this is 10. 30 plus 10 plus 10. This is 50 centimeter. 50. So now sometimes they will give the question, very simple question. They will give like this. Two spheres are separated by a distance of 30 centimeter. So in general, student will take this r value as 30 centimeter, or they will do the numerical. But the distance we should measure from centers of the two bodies. In the same way, next in the concept of law, Newton's law of gravitation also will take distance between centers of the two spheres. Centers of the two spheres. Like that, we can consider this point. This is while you can take it as point mass on this one. So what is meant by point mass or point charge, which means when we are comparing size of the body and distance traveled by the body. If the size of the body is less than the distance traveled by the body, then the body can be considered as a point mass. So point mass is nothing, point mass is not leading to the meaning of small mass. For example, we'll take Earth. So Earth is revolving around the Sun. So size of the Earth is, radius of the Earth is 6,400 kilometer. This is the radius of the Earth. Diameter means double. So when we are comparing the size of the Earth, when we're comparing distance traveled by the Earth around this Sun. So this distance traveled by the Earth is far greater than the size of the Earth. Now, Earth can be considered as point mass. So point mass doesn't mean a small mass. The point mass is nothing but when you're comparing size of the body and distance traveled by the body, when size of the body is less than distance traveled by the body, then the body can be considered as a point mass or point of body. Okay? So these are like, we can take like that. This is the point charges and these are the spherical spheres like that we can take. So when talking about spherical spheres, we can take a distance between centers of the two spheres. That is one of the consideration we can take. Okay. Now this by keeping this removing this proportionality constant, we can write f is equal to some proportionality constant k into q1 q2 by r square. This is f is equal to k into q1 q2 by r square. So what is the value of k? And how this value of k will depend on all, we'll discuss in tomorrow class. We'll discuss about this Coulomb's law. Okay. Now I'll send those questions related to electric charge. You can practice the questions from that electric charge. Then tomorrow we'll discuss Coulomb's law and related. So Coulomb's law, we need to practice more number of numericals. Okay. So this is how based on the each and every concept. We should finish, and based on the same concept, we should practice the numerical. Then we can get clear cut idea about everything on that particular topic. So in this manner, if you discuss all the things, means the examination, whatever may be the difficulty of the paper, you can able to solve that question problem. Okay. So electric charge in general, if electric charge concept will take around 10 to 15 minutes, we can complete electric charge. But regarding this electric charge, how much we discussed, how what are the points, what type of questions they asked based on electric charges, taken almost two classes. Based on methods and all, introduction and methods and all, on a half an hour means, almost more than, almost 2 hours we discussed about electric charge and its properties. Okay, so like that. So electric charge we can complete within 10 to 15 minutes. And also electric charge we can complete within by taking 2 hours of time. So there is a a lot of difference. So now, based on the electric charge, whatever may be the question they may ask in the examination, you can able to answer that question. Okay, like that preparation we need to do as you are related to. That means as you have time to prepare everything, we need to go for each and every point and each and every concept of the particular chapter. Okay.